only about 20% of a patient's health or someone's health is what the doctors in the hospitals do. The rest of the 80 to 90% of someone's health is the environment around them or the so-called social determinants of health.
I've taken care of a family of five generations. So I've had great grandmothers all the way down to great grandchildren. And when you follow that dynamic, you realize how many things can affect your life adversely, and you go out and try to help them.
It's poverty, it's your job, it's your home, it's a city or the countryside in which you live, if you own a car or have transportation access. And so these are all the opportunities that really, at the end of the day, affect someone's health.
If you take an elderly patient who's having balance issues and is unsteady and is weak, and all they need is a grab bar to get in and out of their bathroom or get in and out of their shower, you know they're going to fall if they don't have some help getting in and out of the shower. So if you invest a small amount of money into a grab bar, you may save a lot of money by preventing a hip fracture and an extended hospital stay or a nursing home stay. So a little bit of investment can save a lot of money on the other end.
I don't think doctors have to lead that team. I think they have to be part of it. And just embracing this concept of never discharge. And from the emergency room, that's very important, because in the past we used to just discharge our patients and say follow up with whoever and hope that the patient did that. Now I think you have to make the patient aware and understand that we are not releasing them. You are still with us.
We have a case manager actually in our office who, when we identify a patient that needs help, we can ask her to sort of institute these extra efforts to get people some help at home. So it might be nutrition, it might be access, it might be drugs, it might be caretaking, it might be bathing, it might be safety, it might be security, it might be housing. So they're very attuned to what's available in the community to help.
This message has been brought to you by the Pennsylvania Medical Society, building healthy Pennsylvania communities.